Thank you. հայկական հասարանի գողմեն հուզենք շնորհակալություն հայտնել
մեր ծնողներուն, մեր ուսուցիչներուն,
հոգապարծության
եւ ձոներություն։
You guys aren't gonna forget us either.
քաղաքական դասարանի կողմեն հուզենք շնորհակալություն հայտնել
մեր ծնողներուն, մեր ուսուցիչներուն,
հոգապարծության
եւ ջանարություն։
Վերավարտական դասարանի կողմեն հուզենք շնորհակալություն հայտնել
մեր ծնողներուն, մեր ուսուցիչներուն,
հոգապարծության
և ջանարություն։ You guys aren't gonna forget us either.
հրավարդական թասարանի կողմեն հուզենք շնորհակալություն հայտնել
մեր ծնողներուն, մեր ուսուցիչներուն,
հոգապարծության
և ջնորոշություն։ You guys aren't gonna forget us either.
No, keep aspect ratio. If you do that.
Yeah, change aspect ratio, but it might be small times. Sneak a light is prepared.
Yeah. Let's see, let's show it here. Let's show it in the large section. Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're good in the large section. So we're good here, we're good here. Being
for it, so
what happens is when I'm coming and I want to go out of here, I'm gonna go around.
Like that?
We are streaming live. Sorry.
We're nice.
Streaming live, sir. We're streaming live. Yeah? We're live streaming, thank you very much. Hold that for me. Live streaming now. Thank you very much. I'm gonna start off this language. Hello, what's that? That's loud, thank you. Thank you, let's see. Let's see, Chacha. Hi. Oh, Margaret, how many? You, Margaret, how many? You're live. Thank you.
Make a little bit more than 5 minutes.
Okay.
Sure. Follow your live channel.
You're on now. If you log in now, you see yourself in profile. So you know.
Thank you. Thank you. very best. I think it is the same way that the film in the specialized to be in the modern area of the artist. This area should be the physical performance that everybody is listening to now. So anybody who wants to talk, they can go to the lobby. Next. Manon Erbe Mosian pianist, she will be performing the African Lucas Aliasca and Pencil Sizing Arnold Momentum.
Gracias. Thank you. Alin Arustamian, Alin Arustamian, vocalist, accompanied by Greg Hosharian, pianist. Deleyama Kerekele Hovarek Yerigna Ambela, Gomidas.
I'd like to take this moment to just say a few words. I am so very thrilled to be here tonight celebrating a momentous celebration with AGBU. I know that my grandfather, Tigran Kalustian, would be overjoyed because of his absolute pride, not only in our culture, but his AGBU membership. So that's an awesome thing. William Saroyan wrote about the soul of the Armenian people. And he said in his famous quote that we all know, "Go ahead, try to destroy Armenia, see if you can." Clearly, look around the room, they did not. We are here, and it is an amazing thing. And the brilliant artwork and the stunning music that we are seeing tonight is just a true testament to our extraordinary spirit. So I wanted to just put a spotlight on that and hope you enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
evening by the oh-so-talented, oh-so-gracious Greg Hosharian, who I am so happy to be sharing this evening with his artistry and his musicianship is uncanny, and so thank you, Greg.
Thank you.
Armen Kasajikian, cellist, accompanied by Levon Abrahamian, pianist. Dear friends, monitors are placed at the entrance of the hallway in the art gallery area and the timeline room. So you guys could watch what's going on stage from those other rooms too.
Next piece is Andantino by Aram Khachaturian. I think it's one of the earliest pieces he wrote when he was still in the conservatory, originally for piano, and this version is piano and cello. Thank you.
Mansourian, vocalist Patranki Teverov, Maria Alice.
Շուրջ բոլորն է անցանոտ է, դու ինձ ներին մայրի։ Դու ինձ պրկիր մայրի, որ հակուս չշուկ նուջիչը, չդացնեն ինձ իմ դահիչը, դու ինձ պրկիր մայրի։ Ես ինչ անեմ, մայրի, որան հակ բախտի հարցերը, որան անիմ հասցելերը, ես ինչ անեմ, մայրի, դու ինձ միայն օրնիր, Ach, Yerani, Techusha. Arten gitem, Mayri, Volansatze, Jamanaka, Sahmamatze, Tisakarka. Arten gitem, Mayri, Ishumem, Mist, Mayri. Մեզ լակում է փորձանքները, կյանքն է մեր սիրով արգելքը, հիշում է միշտ մայրի։ Կարկիններին մայրիք, որ անցյալս նախեր դանքը, իսկ ներկաս նրա պատրանքն է, կարկիններին մայրիք։ Ինձ օգնիր, մայրիկ, դու ինձ փրկիր, մայրիկ, ախ Երանի, թևերան եմ, թերջում դարան, հող նեմատալ, ճանապարան եմ,
Thank you. Thank you.
Pleasure to invite Talin Yakupyan, AGBU Western District Committee Chairwoman, with the welcoming remarks.
Good evening. Can everyone hear me?
Yes.
I really apologize for the heat. It's the things that you don't count on that get you in the end, unfortunately. On behalf of the AGBU Western District Board, I'd like to thank you for coming today and extend our warmest greetings to Archbishop Homnal de Iberia for being with us, AGBU Central Board member Sinan Sinanian and his lovely wife Angel, elected officials, AGBU members, honored guests, Reverend clergy, thank you. Thank you for your overwhelming enthusiasm for today's event. As we reflect on the achievements of the last 110 years of our great organization, the question naturally turns to the future. Pope John Paul II famously said, "The future starts today, not tomorrow." It is certainly a brilliant time to consider that question, to consider the future, which I am convinced is full of bright possibilities. Of course, none of us are naive to the challenges that face us. Our road has not been an easy one, and it doesn't promise to be so in the future. We face the challenge of building a fledgling nation. We face aggressive and violent neighbors in the Azeris and the Turks. In the diaspora, we face the fear of integration and losing our Armenian identity. But I have certainty that we will prevail and that our great-grandchildren will be celebrating our legacy and paying tribute to us 100 years from now. How can I be so sure? On April 15th, I was sitting in the gym of the Manukyan Demirjian High School with the entire student body. The kindergartners had bright faces. The middle schoolers were listening with interest. Even the upper schoolers, nonchalantly, but they were listening, singing, and paying attention. And I thought to myself, these kids are our torchbearers. And I felt so proud. Proud to be Armenian and proud to belong to this community. And I bet so are all of you. Our youth are incredibly talented, resourceful, and fearless. They are also more free. Free to think differently, creatively, free to take risks. That freedom is a gift that we have given them and those before us have given them. And just like to anyone to whom much is given, much is expected of them. But I have no doubt that our youth will deliver. Just look around you today. The future of the AGBU Western District will be about collaboration. Everyone's been asking what's going to happen next. We are going to collaborate. We will work with our youth, we will teach them, and we will learn from them. Today you saw a small sample of that collaboration, the masters with the amateurs. This may be a novel and somewhat unorthodox mélange, but we believe this is where the future lies. Technology has been the great equalizer. Knowledge and know-how is much more readily available. We need to leverage our strengths, all of our tools, the young and the old, the diaspora and Armenia. This is the only way we move forward with increased ferocity and strength, unafraid of the unknown and ready to travel and explore the road less traveled. Today's marquee speaker epitomizes this brave new world. He is a true visionary, seeing beyond the big picture. His innovative approach to philanthropy and business is an inspiration to us all. AGBU is proud to introduce him to you personally today, the latest addition to the AGBU Central Board of Directors, and only 1 week after the world watched in awe as the Aurora Prize was awarded. Without further ado, Mr. Rupen Bartanyan. Rupen, thank you again for being here. I know you've traveled quite a distance and arrived actually today. You've been active in philanthropy for a very long time now, and recently you made a decision to join the AGBU board. Can you share with us what that decision was based on?
Good evening. First of all, I want to say thank you very much for inviting me. My big pleasure to be today with all of you in Los Angeles, one of the biggest Armenian community in the world, celebrating oldest and most respected institution, 110th anniversary. You know, and also I would say a special thank you for the song of my sister. Yes, it was very, it's a big surprise, right? Thank you, Degas. You know, AGBU has a unique history, which really looking back, well, you can amaze by vision of Zubar Pasha, who realized how critical it will be for Armenian nation to have an institution which will provide not only philanthropy, by the way, in the beginning, it was not only philanthropy, but also economic development of the Armenian nation. And we're living in a world that's becoming more and more interconnected.
Yeah.
Do we need to change the song? Okay. We are living in a world that's becoming more and more interconnected. I think the point of the looking just each of us separately, saying, okay, this is diaspora, this is Armenia, this is this Western diaspora, Eastern diaspora. I think becoming the time, and we are in the face of the time, and it's all becoming more and more connected to each other. More and more we are facing the situation with the Armenians living in Armenia, coming to live in LA, Armenians living in Russia, Russians, Armenians coming to America, Americans coming to Armenia. I think we are living in a world where it's all this connectivity becoming a very critical element. And AGBU always been played a very important role for keeping identity, keeping the identity of the nation in a different part of the world. We've been with Perch in San Simonian in Brazil, Uruguay, Argentina, and we saw the diaspora there. We're going to London in next 2 weeks. We'll be in London. It's amazing what AGBU achieved during its 110 years, and definitely its legacy which needs to be used for the future. The issue, of course, for all of us, how to use the heritage which we are carrying 5,000 years or more, and looking at the same time looking forward, not the past. But I want to say congratulations again for AGBU 110th anniversary. It's the oldest and most respected institution in Armenian world, and non-political. And I think it's very important also. I think it's a basis for everybody collaborating. I like your wording about collaboration. I think it's one becoming very critical for collaboration for everybody.
You've spoken a lot about
social impact investing, especially in Armenia. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, we all facing interesting, challenging time for all of us, because what's happening in current time in Armenia in April, I think raised very critical questions about the future of our nation. In one hand, we definitely can be proud about our nation, because despite what happened 101 years ago, despite all the problems that we faced during the 20th century, despite all the emigration waves which happened not only from Ottoman Empire, but also from Iran, from Syria, from Lebanon, from Russia, from Armenia, we continue to exist like nation and really proud to be Armenian nation. At the same time, we're facing the reality of the dangers of our neighbor with the war in Artsakh. And if you look at our all activities, it's been always more like charity, separate from the commercial activity. And I believe the 21st century, we're living in a world where it will be more and more will come combination of the social activity and commercial activity become joined, because charity, just doing charity, is not enough. It needs to be self-sustainable. One of the challenges we are facing is for today, and I will be, like I promised, I will be talk very frank. For most of the diaspora, it's in sending money in Armenia is like expense. It's a some way duty, but you need to do it. And it's not self-sustainable. I believe to create the mechanism which will be converting this expense to investment, which will be helping diaspora feel that we've been proud to be Armenian, we'll be proud of going in Armenia, and Armenians be proud of going in diaspora will be very critical. That's why self-sustainable element is one of the critical elements of the future of the Armenian nation. And so we need to convert our charity activity to more to find a way how it can be self-sustainable using all our experience and knowledge which was done by HBU or any other institution. The second, I would say, is very critical with social impact investment. It's a model which can be replicable not only for Armenian world but also for other nations, because entire world facing big challenges. United Nations approved $2 trillion investment in emerging markets in the next 20 years' time. $2 trillion is big money, and they need to invest in the countries which have no infrastructure, no strong institutions like governments, and no strong private sector. So Armenians can be playing an interesting role to be a role model. We've been a role model in First Christianity, been a role model when we published the first book. Now in new technology, 21st century, we again can become pioneer and role model for others, which I believe it will be bring us different attitude about ourselves. Because one of our major challenge is to transfer ourselves from victimization mood to the and survival mood to the prosperity and the winners mood. This is why it's so critical what's going on in Artsakh for all of us. Because Artsakh is not about just war with going in some territory in Caucasus. It's Artsakh is linked to our genocide, because genocide was one of the most difficult events that happened in our nation during our history. And we recovered, and what happened in Aurora Prize, it was celebration of our winning despite what happened to us. And winning not from point of just beating somebody, but winning because we are like nations, survive, stay strong, and can give back. The same in Artsakh, which is why doing some self-sustainable economic development for Armenia is not just our duty, because we need to help our state or our nation living in Armenia, but it's also very critical for ourselves who live in diaspora feel that we are part of the nation who is a winner, not a loser.
You've suggested a very interesting model, but can you be more specific on what that model may look like?
I'm happy. I'm sorry. I see so many people standing up, and it's very hot, and I don't want to take too much time and being too long. But I'm really so thankful to be here with all of you, and forgive me to be answering your questions very giving long answer, and also being a little bit tired if I'm speaking too quickly. Sorry, it's really, I just arrived from 12 hours flight from Moscow. I want to bring one example which I made already once in LA about Datev. Datev Monastery, I know how many of you been in Armenia and Datev Monastery, so the monastery. One of the our jewelry of Armenian Church and University of the medieval years. It was destroyed by earthquake in Soviet time. And when I saw first time, I said, okay, this monastery needs to be renovated. And like we all love the renovating church, building new churches, I said, okay, it's great, it's very important. But I realized to achieve this monastery, it needs to take 6 hours with no basically, without any chance to get by buses. It needs to go by four-wheel cars only. And I said, okay. I said, okay, I will do the renovation monastery, but who will see it? We calculated in 2009 only less than 4,000 people went to see this monastery, despite of the bad road. When we decided to build the cable car cost $12 million, and it was huge investment in this region, because these 9 villages around this monastery was dying because there was no job, it was no infrastructure, people was living in these villages. We built this cable car by $12 million investment, and everybody looked and said, it's crazy, what you're doing is not will work, and what you're doing is wasting money, why you're not just giving money to the villages, and it will be better for farmers to get this money and have a better life, and no, it's not so sustainable, because I will give this money, we'll spend this money, and it's over. This cable car was built in 2010 and was opened. In 2014-2015, 150,000 people went to this monastery, so this monastery. It's around 14 hotels and up to 10 bed and breakfast was open, 10 restaurants, markets, souvenir shops, and the kids started to sing the whore and getting a lot of activities. Unemployment went down 50%, and we got activities which in a place which was nobody ever imagined can be. And we got $1.2 million revenue by this cable car and $300,000 EBITDA, which is going to support the monastery. Can you imagine this is the type of thing that you never can imagine can be happening in the area which was $10,000 was already big money. This is the example about self-sustainable, because today it's not anymore dependent on Ruben Vardayan or anybody else to give money to monastery or not. This cable car supporting the monastery activity and renovation of monastery, which we hope we will finish by 2017. This is an example, just I want to give a small example.
Talked about how we're all connected. The world is shrinking, becoming a smaller place. Artsakh is connected to Armenia. Armenia is connected to the diaspora. And if any one point fails, we all fail collectively. Speaking of these connections, how do you think Armenia can actually help the diaspora?
I think it's a great question, and I think it's very important to talk about this. We have a triangle of the three key elements of it, which I believe is very critical for our future. Is what will happen with diaspora, what's happening with Armenian like state, and genocide, because it's one of the really most critical elements of our mental behavior and hurt everybody. If you look the history of diaspora, and look at the history of Armenian like state. When Armenians was living in our own motherland, it was under Ottoman Empire, Persian Empire, Russian Empire. And we've been always dreaming about Hayanik. It was like El Dorado. You know, I would say, I found this wording in being Latin America. It's a little bit not real. You know, we don't talk about real or Hayastan. Hayastan is today's existence, it's not the our Hayanik. It's a little bit different. El Dorado is something which is dreaming and you never It's always only good things you can think about El Dorado. Nothing bad can happen with them. No corruptions, no inefficiency, no crime, nothing. It's always used to be almost paradise. That's why it's some of the dreaming about El Dorado from diaspora, whereas Armenia was facing blockade, earthquake, war, and just learning to be independent and learning becoming the state, learning to becoming institution which can provide support and services to your nation. It's really great some bad feelings, I would say. Like a little bit people was upset about, disappointed about the mismatching between the reality and dreaming. I think New Armenia, which was established 25 years ago, which will celebrate this year 25th anniversary of the independence, only now slowly becoming the state which really can provide something not only for themselves but from the world. And I want to bring a couple examples. Tumo was established by Sam Simonyan from diaspora in Armenia for Armenian kids. But today Tumo was recognized like best innovative school in the world. Not in Armenia. And if we can open now two more centers in a diaspora, I'm sure it will help diaspora feel very proud, because first time it's not talking about just opening the school or keeping our identity, but really building something which is best of the best coming from Armenia. The same about IPE. The same about the IPE school, which is also established one of the best standards of education. The chess player. We can go some of the examples. And of course, Aurora Prize was one of the goals of Aurora Prize, also about this establishing best and UWC Dilijan and Dante cable car. It's the longest in the world. It's the best by best in a category. It's why Armenian state and Armenian-like country will help diaspora if it will really provide the best standards, best example of something in education, in infrastructure, innovation, in healthcare, which we really can do. The problem for us is we don't believe about this, because we see the past and we always look like negative side, because negative is always easier to discuss, negative is always easier to, takes more attention people. People like to discover negative, positive is like normal. It's why talking about negative is always makes life easier. Say why you're not doing something for Armenia, or why you feel is not everything is going in Armenia is right. The same in diaspora. We're getting in diaspora. Let's be honest, very serious challenges, because diaspora, when the first wave of the immigration happened, was definitely the main goal was adaptation in the new reality, in the new countries, in new places. Most of these countries was non-Muslim, it's Christian countries, which is less aggressive. We've been adaptive in this environment very quickly. We try to give our identity by building the schools, clubs, and we've been very proud to become part of these new societies. And now we're living in a situation where more and more Armenians become disengaged, because we're becoming part of the society that does not belong to one nation but belong to the country where we're living. And the only way we can keep this diaspora engagement is by making Armenia successful and proud, because the proud makes people connected to it, to some stories. And second, if we can really make this global, I would say, global connections between this all diasporas to each other, to feel this type of the advantage of living in 21st century, whereas the people, Armenians living in different parts of the world can be connected to each other. It's why our goal to make Armenia strong, Armenia which can bring not only proud because it's our motherland, but proud because it's a success, and diaspora which will feel not only being proud, for example, Argentina because of the Messi or the Pope, but also because of Tumo in Argentina will be best place, and all Argentina will be dreaming to come in Tumo Armenian Center and study in this place. The pride and fear is the two things which keep us always, all nations, connected. The pride, we now can feel more proud about our history, our past, but we need to build our future and be proud about the future, not only about us. The fear is very critical also. What's happening in Artsakh, and I want to warn all of us, if we lose Artsakh, we'll lose Armenia, we'll lose Armenian nation, okay? It's no question about small territory. Artsakh is our first victory after many hundred years. We need to be connected to each other, we need to help each other to stay strong in Armenia and in diaspora, help each other. And it's no problem if people in immigration will go, it's two-side street. Some Armenian will go to America, some American Armenian will go to Armenia. It's a very good exchange of the ideas, experience, and different culture. We like nation, we've been one of the strongest nation who have the chance to live in history in different parts of the world and be adapted very well in different civilizations. We don't realize how successful we've been living in Shi'i culture, Sunni culture, Greek Orthodox culture, and always doing trading and be accepted by all these nations until 19th century. It's a big advantage for 21st century we can use for our building our future success. But this needs to be used very well. It needs to be done together, and we need to become more linked to each other. We need to become more ready to go out of the ghetto mentality. Because unfortunately, in Armenia, in LA, and I will be very frank, Armenia is the same like in LA, which is the biggest spurk outside of Armenia. It's a little bit ghetto mentality. It's a closed mindset. We need to become open mindset mentality. We need to think how we can connect, how our kids, we're looking now at Facebook. Look, Facebook is the best example of the connection of Armenians we can use without, we use the Facebook without Facebook, right? We learn to be connected to each other because somebody from Argentina came or in Canada, from Canada to Russia, and they all been Armenian, they connect immediately to each other. Today, 21st century technology allowing us to be more connected. And I believe if we can reuse this technology, use our adaptivity advantage, we really become strongest nation in the world.
Any final thoughts, words of advice? I'm not gonna keep you up here much longer, nor everyone else standing.
No, I'm glad to answer any questions that you want to ask me. Because again, my privilege. I was born in Armenia. I grew up in Armenia until I was 17 years old. When I was 17 years old, I went to Russia and I built my business in Russia. But this business was very international. I have a unique opportunity to link this different world to each other. One thing I want to say, all of us, we need to be very, very patient and understand this is really very, quite a lot of effort from all of us to try to understand each other. And our advantage being one nation living in different part of the world, giving us advantage, but this advantage is not given. We need to also earn it. We need to work and try to learn how to use this. We need to send our kids in Russia without scaring. We need to send our kids in a summer camp in Armenia. We need to create the infrastructure which will help us to learn from each other all these advantages which we're not using enough well. So I want to wish all of us understanding that our future, our kids, to keep staying Armenians, will be only if we really can understand how to use this, all our advantages, how to build this, that will be the new Armenian nation with the strong state, Armenia, and strong diaspora, and being proud and learn to be a winner. And this is a very important transformation because we like diaspora. We got access to the countries because we've been victimized. We've been moving from our own motherland because of the genocide, because we're first time needs to learn to feel not like victim, but like winner. And this is a very important transformation. We need to become winners. We have some videos, but I don't think it's
Can you guys see the signal?
I don't think it's also, it's not visible. Very light. No.
Very lightly. Okay. All right. Well, we will save that then for a future trip.
Yeah, we'll introduce that. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Know something like this doesn't come together without the assistance of a lot of people, and I won't belabor the thank yous, but I do want to thank our board who are here standing around, and especially our board members are consist of 9 members and 2 liaisons for our 2 largest chapters, the San Fernando Valley chapter and the Pasadena Glendale chapter. And those 2 guys, Herant Vartspedian and Herak Ohannesian, no is not in their vocabulary. Whatever I ask, it happens right away. And I am so honored and privileged to be serving with such amazing people, such an amazing board, and especially such devoted volunteers. Volunteerism is a homegrown skill, and it's something that we should all be nurturing. So I would like to invite Herak Ohannesian and Herant Vartspedian to come and accept an award from our 2 central board members, Sinan Sinanian and Ruben Martanian. Thank you.